dad's hat was special. But what made it so special?
George, come on, it's time to go. When I put my hat on, I'm all ready to head out the door. Okay, George, that was funny, but you know the rule. No one is allowed to play with the yellow hat.
George sure liked that yellow hat. George's cap just wasn't special.
I'd like to return these. They were yellow, but after only one washing, they turned saffron.
I have to make a big speech, and I need to know my shorts are yellow.
Like a hat of your own, George? Well, which hat do you like?
George wanted a big yellow hat, but there was only one of those in the world.
You could try different hats till you find what feels right for you.
So George began his quest for headgear.
Hey, where's George today? Didn't recognize you. That's not a city kid hat. Some hats are right for some people and some aren't.
George's friends didn't appreciate any of his headgear. Picking the right headgear was not easy. What made the yellow hat so great? It was just plain fun.
George, I need to wear the hat for an important speech at the museum. Please don't play with it.
That's what George wanted. A fun hat that he could play with. George wanted his fun hat to be more than just a normal hat. He'd use his cap for shape. He would need an opening. Because that would be his ice cream dispenser. But it wasn't fun when it froze the top of his head and then melted and leaked. To solve these problems, George used heavy poster board. And raisins instead of ice cream for a fun, healthy snack.
Oh.
Now, if you could just figure out what hunger would like. Wasn't impressed with George's fun hat until he saw it had doors and dachshunds. His dog friends were taken care of, but what would a cat like?
Like this, I may never have gotten my yellow one.
That was the best thing anyone ever said to George.
You want me to have it? This is the best thing anyone ever gave me. Oh, surprisingly comfortable. You want me to wear it outside? Sure, why not?
Good afternoon. Oh, some chapeau.
George made it.
Having people see the man with the yellow monkey fun hat made George feel very proud.
Sharky! Oh, easy, girl! Oh, no! I'm late! George, I've got 5 minutes to get to the museum for my speech! I have to make a good impression!
George was tempted to play with the yellow hat. But the man had asked him not to, because he needed to wear it to give a very important speech at the museum. Oh, boy.
Hi, George! Hi, George!
And if an apple traveling at the speed of light hits a static banana...
Oh! Everyone's here already. Great. Professor Wiseman asked me to speak today about the scientific method. Of course, we've all heard the saying, what goes around comes around. Haven't we? Did I say something wrong?
No, continue. This is fascinating.
Oh, it stuck to my hat. Oh!
I'm wearing George's... Actually, I can explain.
The scientific method is about thinking creatively, taking chances, and being willing to fail.
And you made that point very dramatically.
I did?
Oh, so modest.
Now, where can I get a hat like that? Well, George made it.
I want one.
I want two.
And that's how George got his picture on the museum wall.
Curious George is a monkey, so he can do things that you can't. He was playing around with the man's yellow hat. We are gonna make hats from stuff in our junk box. We are making hats that have some sort of use or just for fun. First, we are just trying different materials. Now, we are making drawings to design our hats.
This is my design. These are the binoculars. First we designed them, then we built them.
Jerry started his hat with a little trash can lid.
These are the binoculars. I can't see through the binoculars exactly. So I'm putting tape under the binoculars so just to stay in one place. And I'm pretty sure that it might work. It's much more clear than it was before. That's it. TV.
This is a TV hat.
We're watching the Isabel show.
Yeah. This is my entertainment hat. And my basic design is this. The stick is holding up my holder-upper holder. Then this is my tic-tac-toe board. I also have a water bottle on it. That's kind of bringing too much weight to one side. As you can see, Adrian is making a robot helmet.